shit has to be fucked up for people to normally change or to seek something else. What was it about you that you started having the success with something you worked so hard for and but you still wanted to like make a left turn and, you know, you add on things and now it's, you know, coaching's your main deal and giving up, you know, the chiropractic business altogether. Like, how did you decide, shit, this is working, this is great, I got money and everything's good and still want to change? Most people have those golden handcuffs forever.
Comfort is the killer of all dreams. And once we stop having a dream or having a vision or holding to our vision, a lot of people don't have visions in their life. I'm assuming you do, Gary. You're a visionary. You're all about vision, right? So,
but it was one of those things. I didn't.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was one of those things where, like I said, when I hit that financial peak, it was that being unfulfilled. Like, it was great. I mean, I was making great money, but the practice wasn't what I really wanted to have. I had a coach who kind of told me, like, hey, just help people, meet them where they are with their health. Don't worry about, nobody's going to want to be like you when it comes to health. And I said, well, that's fine. I'm not trying to make prototypes of me. I'm just trying to help elevate people to the highest level I possibly can. Cause I looked at everything from a holistic standpoint, chiropractic, nutrition, emotional healing, all these kind of things.